Sanders. Sir, it's great to have you with me today. And, you know, the president is definitely continuing his PR move, a full court press, meeting with small business leaders today. And I just had Senator Johnson on earlier in the hour, who said that he's a small business owner. The president would have been wise to invite him to this meeting to talk to him about what he thinks about what could happen with the fiscal cliff. What do you think about the president's PR move so far? And what he's doing.
Well, I wouldn't call it a PR move. I think what the president is doing is saying, we just came from a campaign. One of the key issues in that campaign is whether or not we ask the wealthiest people in this country to start paying their fair share in taxes. And pretty overwhelmingly, in the presidential election, in Senate elections, the American people said yes. They said that the middle class is disappearing. The richest people in this country are doing phenomenally well. Their effective tax rate, as Warren Buffett often reminds us, is very, very low. And fairness dictates that the wealthy and large corporations start paying their fair share of taxes so that we could deal with deficit reduction in a responsible way. What the president is simply doing is going around the country, I guess to Pennsylvania today, and say, yeah, what do you think out there? And you know what I think? I think that there is no state in this country, no state, where people think that we give tax breaks to billionaires and at the same time cut Social Security, Medicare, and Medicaid. So I think the president is simply reminding the people what the election was about, what poll after poll is about.
The New York Times, as you bring up the entitlement programs, the New York Times reporting today that efforts to reform those such programs, those safety net programs, they're meeting resistance from Democrats on the Hill. Earlier, I mentioned how I had the opportunity to speak to your colleague, Senator Ron Johnson, about a letter written by AFL-CIO's Richard Trumka, basically saying that the right has become a hostage of the American economy. Do you feel that way, and how these negotiations to try to save the country from going over the fiscal cliff, do you feel that they have taken the economy basically hostage?
Well, I think this is what the record indicates. For the first time in American history, to the best of my knowledge, the Republicans in 2011 were prepared not to pay our debts, not to raise the debt ceiling, and allow the United States of America to default on its what it owes, which could have driven this entire world into a major financial crisis. And they said, hey, we are not going to raise tax breaks for the rich, and if it means an international financial crisis, so be it. Well, you know what I think? I think that's being a bully. I think that is hostage taking. I think back in 2010, and by the way, Thomas, in the midst of this whole fiscal cliff discussion, we have got to remember that between 2010 and 2011, we have already, as a Congress, against my votes, but cut over $1 trillion in programs that help low-income people, working people, middle-class people. The wealthiest up until now have not paid a nickel more in taxes. So I would answer your question by saying the Republicans have been very clear in saying that their job is to represent the largest corporations and the wealthiest people, and up until this point, they have succeeded.
Well, when we talk about the fact that so many Republicans recently have voiced the fact that they will break Grover Norquist's anti-taxing pledge, certain leaders and colleagues of yours right there that you work with every day, do you think that they mean it? Do you think that they will put revenues on the table and work with you to make something happen over the next 35 days?
Well, I certainly hope so, and every poll that I have seen tells me that is what the American people want. But the word revenue is a very, very big big word. You can raise revenue by doing away with the mortgage tax deduction, which will hurt middle-class families. The real question is, are the Republicans willing to deal with the fact that while the wealthiest people become wealthier, their effective tax rate is low? Are they willing to deal with the reality that we are losing $100 billion every single year because the wealthy and large corporations are stashing their money in the Cayman Islands? Are they willing, and other tax havens, are they willing to deal with the fact that one out of four major corporations pays nothing in taxes? Are they willing to deal with the fact that we have tripled military spending since 1997? So the bottom line here is, it's not just revenue, it is where is that revenue going to come from? At a time when we have the most unequal distribution of wealth and income of any major country on earth, and that gap between the very rich and everybody else is growing wider, the question is, will the Republicans ask the wealthiest people and their campaign donors, people who make these big campaign contributions, and the super PACs to start paying their fair share of taxes.
Senator Bernie Sanders, sir, great to see you today. Thanks for your time.
Thank you very much.
The race to replace Jesse Jackson Jr., a special election now set to fill his seat in the House of Representatives. Could another Jackson replace him, like his wife? Coming up next, though.